So hello everyone, and welcome to the Moodle Academy webinar, What is the MEC? I'm Anna Kersa, I'm Education Advisor and MEC Coordinator here at Moodle HQ, and I'm joined by Mary Kuch, our Education Manager. Now, today we are going to discuss about the Moodle Educator Certificate. What is it? What its theoretical basis? How does it work? And how can you benefit from it? And of course, how can you get it? So let's begin with the basics and see what is the Moodle Educator Certificate. The MEC is an international certificate for teaching with Moodle by Moodle. And it is offered through our international network of authorized Moodle partners and Moodle partners that have been have specialized personnel that will guide you through the MEC certification process and can also assist you with the Moodle training if that's a requirement. Of course, if you are a training or educational authority and you have more than 50 educators to take through the MEC, you might be interested in offering the MEC to your employee using the MEC Direct option. MEC Direct is basically a subscription model to the MEC. In this case, we, Moodle HQ, will train one or more skilled members of your educational training organization, who will then take the educators of your organization through the MEC program in a private and dedicated area on the MEC site. So if you are interested in the MEC, you can send us an email at education@moodle.com. Now, MEC, the form we are offering today, has initiated in May 2020. And by now we have around 60 MEC facilitators who work for approximately 40 Moodle partners, and they have certified about 520 candidates. MEC is offered in 8 languages, and I must say I'm really proud for this, in English, Spanish, Portuguese, French, Arabic, Chinese, Japanese, and German. And this is thanks to our Moodle partner network. MEC is dynamic, and we might have at some point more languages to be included, like Hungarian and Romanian. And of course, keep in mind that some of these translations may be work in progress. And despite the English content, there are partners who offer the content in English, but they offer support in native languages like Greek and Italian. So yes, it's a multilingual product. Now let's see, what is the theoretical basis behind the MEC? In 2017, European Commission released the European Framework for Digital Competences of Educators. And perhaps you know it as DigCompEdu. Now, despite its European origins, this framework is quite popular worldwide. And this framework organizes educators' professional and pedagogic competencies, as well as learners' competencies, into 6 areas. These are the professional engagement area, the teaching and learning, the digital resources, the assessment, the empowering learners, and the facilitating learners' digital competence area. Now, overall, this framework contains 22 competencies organized in these 6 areas. And if we take a closer look, we can see, for example, that in the teaching and learning area, we talk about collaborative learning, self-regulated learning, teaching, and guidance. So the question when it comes to the MEC is, how do we apply all this in Moodle? And that's basically the answer that candidates need to answer. To be honest, not just answer, but they also need to prove that they know how to apply these competencies using Moodle. So, in other words, MEC is a certification process focused on meeting learners' needs with Moodle in teaching and learning, and also in the professional engagement of educators and the facilitation of learners' digital competencies. MEC consists of six courses. Be careful, not training courses. I'm talking about six certification courses. Six courses that are unique for all partners and all our organizations that are offering MEC through the MEC Direct. And the fact that we have only six courses basically ensures quality. So no matter if you are taking the MEC with a partner in Latin America or in Asia or in Europe, you will still take the same six courses. And these courses lead to six badges. And once someone has all the six badges, is eligible for the MEC certificate. So how is the MEC offered? I mean, how is it possible to have six unique courses in different languages offered by different partners who basically each partner is a whole different business, business entity from all over the world? Well, the answer is the magic of Moodle Workplace. I'm not sure if you are aware about Moodle Workplace. Moodle Workplace is a special version of Moodle that contains all the features of Moodle LMS, plus some advanced features designed for workplace learning. So we are hosting MEC in a Moodle Workplace site. It's the education.moodle.com. How it works? Well, we have first built the six courses, as you can see them here. Easy. And then we created, we grouped these courses into the MEC program. And saying program is another Moodle Workplace feature, which creates a learning path for the end users. And another feature that Workplace offer us is the ability to have tenants. Tenants are isolated entities with their look and feel, structure, and users on their own. So for each of our partners, we have a separate tenant. But all the partners, all the tenants, have access to the MEC program and in its six courses. So the courses run in separate group mode. So users from one tenant don't see the users from the other tenant at all. Now, Moodle Academy is commissioned and has collaborated on a new plugin with external and internal developers to create the translations filter that facilitates the content translation within the courses. So when a user changes the system language, besides the system language that changed, it also changed the course content into that language. And I'm underlining this feature because it is essential not only for accessibility reasons, but also for the certificate's quality. I mean, no matter where someone is taking the MEC or with which partner, the value of the certificate at the end of the day will be the same, recognized worldwide. But that was all the technicalities behind the MEC, and I just wanted to highlight how things are done and how strict we are about quality and ensuring that we have one unique product despite the partners and the organizations that are offering it. So let's go now see how these courses, what do the certification courses look like. So when you join a Moodle partner to take the MEC, they will register you in the MEC site and you will be allocated to the MEC program. Just give me a second, like my computer. All the MEC courses have the same structure. So we can take a closer look just in one of them and see, for example, the teaching and learning course. Now, the courses start with a welcome section that includes the announcements form and the How This Course Works book, with all the essential information of how to successfully complete this course, basic things. The next section is the What Do You Already Know? And it contains a self-assessment quiz. Now, this quiz has been based on the questionnaire created for the Selfie for Teachers program, which is also connected with the DigCompEdu framework. The third section, Teaching and Learning Overview, the overview section, begins with a forum for general questions and contains the main course content, books and quizzes. Each book examines one competence. It describes the competence, it contextualizing it within Moodle. And then there is a formative quiz that allows candidates to confirm their understanding. So the book focuses on the competence, not on how to add an activity or a resource in Moodle or how to do things in Moodle. It focuses mostly on the competence and how we can express this competence within Moodle. This is a knowledge, the how to do things in Moodle is a knowledge that candidates should already have. The number of the book and quiz pairs depends on the number of competencies each area has. So some course may have 3 sets, some course have 4, and one of them has 5. Specifically, the teaching and learning course that we see here has 4 competencies. So we have a pair for teaching, for guidance, for collaborative learning, and for self-regulated learning. Then we have the Your Assess Task is the 4th section, and it contains the actual assessment activities. Here we have a scenario-based quiz and an assignment. Now, the scenario-based quizzes offer a unique journey through diverse experiences in the educational landscape. Something's wrong with my camera today.
Not to worry, we can still see your presentation, and that's the important thing. So you just keep going with the presentation, Anna. That's fine. We can see that.
I was saying that the scenario-based quizzes offer a unique experience because candidates through diverse experience in the educational landscape. So participants are immersed in the roles of educators from primary or secondary education, from tertiary education and vocational training. So their task is to make crucial decision for each case, mirroring real life educational scenarios. Now, the assignment requires candidates to speak from their own experience. They must submit answers between 500 to 800 words, reflecting on their own teaching experience with Moodle, and cover every competence. Candidates must include screenshots of courses they have run and created, offer, obviously, or they can include a link to a course, giving facilitators, of course, permission to access it. For the assignments, candidates can resubmit twice after the first grading and feedback, and the pass grade is set at B2 level. Now, what's the B2 level? Let's see. Assignments are evaluated with a rubric like the one we see here. So vertically are the four competencies of the teaching and learning course. And horizontally, you can see the levels that vary from A to B1, B2, C1, C2. Now, DigCompEdu framework was supplemented with a competence rubric based on the Common European Framework of Reference for Languages. This framework consists of six levels, each with specific descriptors that outline the skills and the competencies expected at every level. So at A1, we have those who have a basic language knowledge. In B2, those that can fluently interact, and at C2, interpreters and translators. Similarly, in the context of our certification, if you are standing at levels A1, A2, it's too soon for you to think about the MEC. You still need to get some experience, you might even need some training. But if you are at level B1, then perhaps you're a good candidate to start MEC, as it would mean that you are a regular user, but perhaps you haven't considered those competencies in detail. So if you are at level B2, of course, you are certainly a pass for the MEC, as you would be an expert. And if you're studying at level C1, it means that you already are a leader in the field. And if you are at C2, then you are an innovator, a top trainer. So the last section of an MEC certification course is the where to go from here. This section contains a reflections form, and it is available only for those who have successfully completed the assessed tasks. And there is an optional retake of the self-assessment quiz, and of course, a course evaluation. Should we check a little bit the chat, Mary? What do you think?
Well, there was just a clarification made for Susan there. So you showed a screenshot of Rajesh, who I think was a school teacher in one of the scenario-based quizzes. Mm-hmm. So that is a quiz. So you have to read his situation and then choose the best alternative solution for his problem, and then the other two people in their situations. And then the assignment, which is the other assessed task, that is the one where you have to add your own screenshots of your course or a link to your course and talk about your own experience. Other than that, I think we can carry on. Anna?
Yes, thank you. Thank you for the clarification. Where do I start? I mean, where do you start, actually? I will answer, it depends on where you are standing at right now. So if you can see here the mountain, you can see that MEC requires some educational background and a good understanding of Moodle. The MEC is right on the top of the mountain. So if you are a newcomer or explorer, you fit in the gray area, the light gray area, you should better start with some Moodle training. So you might refer to Moodle partners or to Moodle Academy. But if you are a regular user and you do have some teaching experience with Moodle, then you fit probably into the orange area of our mountain, and you can actually take the MEC readiness check to see how ready you are for it. The MEC readiness check is in the course that you've joined us today from. Now, regarding the training, allow me to make things more explicit for the newcomers and the beginners. So if you feel that you can deal with self-paced learning, you may start from a Moodle Academy. So in Moodle Academy, we have three learning pathways: for educators, for administrators, and for developers. The courses that we offer are free and open to everyone, and they are self-paced. In each of the three pathways, there are, despite the standalone courses, some and webinars, basic and intermediate programs. So if you are interested in the MEC, you should start with the Moodle Teaching Basics and the Moodle Teaching Skills programs. The Moodle Teaching Basics is a beginner level program, and the Moodle Teaching Skills is an intermediate level program. So remember that these courses are self-paced. If self-paced learning is not for you, and if you prefer facilitated training, then you should better contact one of our partners. So they can guide you through Moodle training and then continue for the MEC. So if you have some experience in teaching with Moodle already, and if you are now wondering if you are ready for the MEC, all you have to do is check the links in Moodle Academy and take the pre-placement test. Depending your score in this quiz, it's just a self-assessment check. Depending the score and how well you'll go to that, you will be guided if you can if you proceed with the MEC, or if you should oriented to take some training. So pretty much that's all from me. I would like to see if we have more questions or anything else. Hello, Emmanuel.
Yes, I think there was some confusion with Bello's application. So I've just said to get in touch with us and we can investigate. Susan says, is there a handy link to the self-assessment quiz for MEC? If you mean the Are You Ready for MEC quiz, I can post the link in here. But as Anna said, it is actually in the course where you are, if that's what you mean. Yes.
Yes, yes, that's I did the self-assessment quiz before signing up for this webinar, but I wondered if there was just a link that I could then revisit it.
If you just click on it, I suppose. You found it than I did. That's great, Anna.
Yeah. Open.
Oh yes, of course. Yes. Okay.
Yeah. But again, you will take the quiz and then you will need to contact in one of the authorized Moodle partners who offer the MEC.
I got 6.67 out of 10. Is that enough?
Well, it will tell you, won't you? When you reach the end, it will give you an evaluation as to whether you're ready or not.
Yeah, I don't remember by heart. I think it's like B1 where you are. So
yeah.
I think you are good. Now, Emmanuel is asking about the cost of the MEC. Well, this varies from partner to partner. I mean, we have a standard cost of 200 euros for the certificate. And this is a standard fee. But partners charge differently around the world, depending for the facilitation and for the support throughout the certification process. Usually, the cost varies from 200 to 400, depending the partner. Something like that.
Yeah. If that's okay, Emmanuel, I will answer Michael's question. And Michael's asking, is this a useful program if your role is more as an administrator or technical support to demonstrate competency in Moodle? If not, is there an alternative for admins? Well, if your role includes supporting teachers and you know how to teach with Moodle, definitely it's worth exploring the Moodle Educator Certificate, the MEC. However, if you are an admin, then on Moodle Academy, we have admin basics and admin skills, basic and intermediate level training. But we are working on currently a Moodle Administrator Certification, MAC, as opposed to MEC, which we're hoping to have launched by the end of this year. Currently writing the courses, then they need to be tested and improved and so on. So the answer is there an alternative for admins? Watch this space. Yep. I'll just, Emmanuel, can we have the conditions to be a partner? I don't think universities can be Moodle partners, actually, Anna. I think you have to be a commercial company. You might know better, Anna.
Well, it's becoming a partner is a whole different story, yeah. Like becoming a certified Moodle partner or service provider. This is completely different story, and you should better refer to the Moodle.com site for more information. But if you are asking about the MEC direct process, which means that we will have some kind of collaboration as far as it concerns the MEC, then the prerequisites is to be a training organization or educational institution, something, and have more than 50 educators to take through the MEC. In the case of the MEC Direct, be careful, you cannot sell the MEC to a wider audience. It's just for organization to train their own employees. So these are restrictions.
Are there any other questions? Anyone who is interested in doing this or think they might be right level? Hello, Bello.
Hello, this is Emmanuel.
It was Emmanuel first.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
Yes. Well, I wanted to have a follow-up question on my earlier question that I asked. How do I get certified if I go through the program? And I think that 200 euro from my part of the world in Ghana is very, very high. I don't know if you have any local partner in Ghana that can charge a subsidized fee.
Okay, Anna, this is a very good question for you to respond to.
Indeed, indeed. This is a demanding case. The point is that we cannot offer the same certificate in various prices around the world. That will be unfair. The certificate that will take, either you will take it in Ghana, either you take it in London, will have the same value. So it needs to be the same. We often have this, we have partners underlying the difference around the world, but we cannot offer the same certificate in different costs. And that would raise a bad competition between partners as well. So this is not an option. That's why we offer the MEC direct option, because through the MEC direct, large organizations can cut completely the cost of the facilitation. But this is something that we review case by case.
Yes.
Yeah, so assuming I'm able to pay for the 200 euro and I'm satisfied, what is in for me? What will be my role in Ghana here? Because I intend to really help institutions in Ghana here with the Moodle platform, because I've been using it for the last 5 years, helping my own university that I'm running in Ghana here. And I also run a small business, and I intend to use Moodle to help institutions. I mean, small institutions are like tertiary universities and then technical vocational centers and etc. So what will be my role after paying the 200 euro and to get satisfied?
Well, this is something different. The MEC is for educators who want to have the best quality of service, the best understanding of education. What you're looking for is to set up a business model And MEC can be an asset for your business model, but it's not the certification that will give you this ability. There is a big difference between what a Moodle partner does and what a user from with MEC is eligible to do. An MEC, a user who owns the MEC, is an educator, a certified educator, who knows how to use Moodle good enough, or in a very high level, I would say not good enough, just. But a Moodle partner is the entity that is eligible to offer Moodle trainings, Moodle support, hosting, and all the stuff. It's completely different business models. I would say that you should take a look at the certified service providers link and Moodle partner that Mary is sharing here.
Also, if I understand it correctly, if you look at that provider link to find someone who can take you through the MEC, you can filter by certification MEC. If there isn't a partner in your country, you can go to another partner in a nearby region. Or if there isn't one in your language, you can find a partner who does speak your language, because everything is online, so it's not geographically dependent.
And of course, this is also one reason that we don't offer different prices
Correct.
For the certificate. Yes, Belon?
Yes.
All right, thank you very much.
Okay, good morning or good afternoon, everyone. So I'm coming back with my worry about the MEC that I already, where I already started the process. I already passed the test and everything was okay. I was prompted to to a partner. I think it was in South Africa or Nigeria. I don't really remember well. And later on, I received a mail that he was no more partner of Moodle. And I had to wait for a mail to be assigned to another partner. So I don't know now. When I see the process through which we have to go in order to be MEC certified, it is a little bit different, as I think at that time, it's more than 1 year ago, we didn't have to go through the platform and so on. So I don't remember very well, but I am a user of Moodle since 2014, I think. And I worked in secondary school, in university with platform, and currently I am digital learning specialist at Aflatun International. I don't know if you know about it, based in the Netherlands, working in social and financial education. Mm-hmm. And also, but I am based in Cameroon. I'm just traveling and coming back whenever we have a grouping and so on. And here in Cameroon, I have started a training academy. And that is where there is a part that interests me. You said we can be partner with like MEC and so on, having 15 educators and so on. So maybe later, I don't know who I will write to.
Yes. Let me take you to the link to review the requirements and information page for the MEC Direct. You must be careful. MEC Direct is offered in specific cases, in specific organization. It's not something that, it's a subscription model that we will only offer to institutions, to training institutions, not to businesses, not to companies. Because MEC Direct is for universities or for organizations that are acting as training institutions and are interested to train their own users in the use of Moodle, not for them to sell the MEC in the way Moodle partners do. So it's completely different. The requirements are very, very specific for that. You can see more details in the site I'm showing here.
Yeah, I just sent the link in the chat there to the MEC Direct link on Moodle.com. So that gives you all the information.
And okay, no problem. Okay, but I have my question is about my own certification.
Yeah.
Now, do I need to go through all the process again?
Or... you should. You haven't been redirected yet, right?
No, I have been direct in the past. I was directed to.
Yes,
partner.
And then yes. Do you have another facilitator now?
No, not yet.
Then this is something that should go to the channel manager. So,
you can email us, actually. I think earlier in the chat below, did I send you the link? If you can contact us, we can help sort this out for you and get you with another partner who is still a partner, because I think the problem was you were allocated to someone who then stopped being a partner. Emmanuel, you have your hand raised. Did you have another question?
Yes, please, Mary. I'm just trying to make meaning from the slides on the screen now. Does it mean MEC Direct involve 50 educators to be certified at a cost of 200 euro, or the 200 euro is for an individual? That is
for
one.
Individual.
That's the first question. The second question is that educators like Bello, he has shared his challenges. Does it mean that if one has to go through this training and get certified as an individual, especially from me, from Ghana, what is the process involved? What are the issues that I'm likely to face? Am I supposed to be certified directly with your institution, or you give me an agent in my region, let's say West Africa? You know, of course, he's in Cameroon. I'm also in Ghana. We are all in West Africa. Do you have partner within this region to offer that certification?
I think we have a South African partner, Anna, yeah?
Yes, we do have in the area. I think there are a couple of them. I'm sorry, I don't remember the names by heart, but you should go to the moodle.com/partners and filter the partners list based on the certification, the service of certification. They can and contact them directly.
Okay, thank you very much. All right.
So I don't know. Sorry, it means we can we choose the partner with whom we want to proceed in the certification? I don't know if I understand well or mistook it.
Yes, Mary, can you please provide the URL in the chat of for the partners?
Yeah,
you did already.
I provided the link for specifically for South Africa, but also the link for any service providers. I'll just share that as well so that anyone in any country can look. But remember, you're not necessarily tied to a particular country there. So that's the general link. And then you can filter by certification MEC.
Seems like... we are almost done, Mary.
Okay, shall we just do a few closing comments then? Thank you so much for coming and for all of your questions. We'd really like it if you could help us to grow Moodle Academy by, for example, getting involved by suggesting topic ideas that we can cover in future webinars. The popular ones, then we always try to run a webinar on them. We have a Get Involved course, and if you join there, you can suggest an idea. If you are an experienced Moodler, you could co-present a webinar or help co-create courses. You get badges for these as well to share on social media. And very important and close to my heart is if English is not your first language, you could help translate our Moodle Academy courses into your own language. And we have a course called Translate Moodle Academy, which you can do to understand the process of translating the courses. And this is exactly what Anna was explaining about the six courses on the MEC also being translated into different languages. And if we can move on.
Yeah.
Yes.
So this one interests me much because I am a French translator. That is, even I have a degree in comparative contrastive of English and French and translation. So I would really be glad, depending on the time allocation it is going to take. So I would really be interested in doing this part of translation and even co-creating. So I don't know.
Take the Translate Moodle Academy course, and then you can see what you think. That would be very helpful. Okay.
Okay.
And finally, if you can help us spread the word by telling your friends and colleagues about Moodle Academy and about the MEC, if you take any of our courses on Moodle Academy, you will get a badge. Also, please tell people that we have regularly run webinars and they're advertised on the front page of Moodle Academy. And if you found this presentation useful and are interested in the MEC, do go and take the quiz, Are You Ready for MEC? And spread the words to others. But I think if we have no more questions, we're probably ready now to finish. So thank you very much from me and Anna.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us today. I hope you find interesting information about the MEC, and I hope we will meet in the future through the MEC sometime.
Goodbye.